Prophecy. On today's Prophecy in the News, we want to introduce you to a brand new book on the market. This book is called The Exodus Case by Dr. Lennart Moller. And this book is the book that gives us all of the documentation of the work that was done that you will see in the video and even more than that. Gary Stearman is here to discuss with me The Exodus Case.
And J.R., this is maybe the most exciting book we've ever offered. There's no doubt about it. Now, in the past, we've offered The Exodus Case, The Exodus Reveal, which is a VHS video. We've also offered the DVD version of The Exodus Revealed, showing those remarkable pictures of chariot wheels on the bottom of the Red Sea. But J.R., this book, The Exodus Case, and it is truly a case study by Dr. Lennart Moller. He's a Swedish doctor. Actually, he's a medical doctor who got his degree from the Karolinska Institute of Stockholm, Sweden. After that, he studied marine biology and chemistry, and then he got interested in archaeology. And what resulted from this combination of Bible belief, the study of Bible history, the study of medical science, pathology, toxicological studies, all came together in The Exodus Case, and boy, does it ever make a case.
You know, he's the gentleman who took a boat and an underwater camera down to the Gulf of Aqaba, found the location, the crossing site, which was in Bible days called the Red Sea, and he put the underwater camera down and went across the 8-mile length of that crossing site and picked up pictures of chariot wheels and all kinds of debris from that disaster that happened to Pharaoh's army, and it's still there after 3,400 years.
J.R., I want to just say one thing about this book. Now, I'm holding this book, The Exodus Case, and you can't tell by looking at me, but this is a heavy book. This book, I don't know what it weighs, but it's an amazingly heavy book. Every page is clay-coated, polished stock, four-color printing, gorgeous pictures, page after page after page. And what reminded me of this was J.R.'s mention of the chariot wheels. There is an exposition in this book of those chariot wheels, J.R., that's absolutely fascinating.
Yes, I'm looking at page 210, 211, and following, and there are picture after picture after picture after picture of the chariot wheels and the axles. And in fact, he takes one picture and then he puts the picture beside it and draws an outline around what can be seen in that picture. And then, of course, underneath the pictures explains what's there. It's just fabulous to see these things. And Gary, the different kinds of chariot wheels,
yes,
that are available as well was interesting to me.
Well, what's interesting, I'm looking at page 211 here, and we're going to put assorted pictures on the screen so you can see as we speak, but we have here the four-spoke type chariot wheel. Now, they're different wheels, but Dr. Muller documents these wheels historically, and he shows how the four-spoke chariot wheel, samples of which are found on the Red Sea floor, comes from the 18th dynasty of Egypt. Now, that's the reign of Thutmose III. So the very shape and design of the chariot wheels sets an approximate date for the Exodus. This is fascinating.
Dozens and dozens of pictures here of the debris on the sea floor with outlines showing exactly what you're looking at. And Gary, when we go over to page 218, he shows a bone, a human femur bone. That's the one that runs from the hip down to the knee. And this was picked up off of the seabed of the Red Sea, right off the floor. And he compares it to a modern bone and shows you this is indeed a human bone, and has a diagram here. Of course, this is a medical doctor we're talking about. He shows the human skeleton where the femur bone is located. Then he has a picture here of skeletons with a skull and the ribs and what have you from humans. And then he gets over to the cattle on page 222. He starts showing cattle skeletons that he picked off of the seabed. And gets over to page 223, he shows the horses' skeletons. So they had oxen to pull some of the heavier carts and horses to pull the chariots, and they are all there, and they are still there. That's what's so amazing to me. And Gary, before we go any further, let me just tell you how you can get a hold of this book. You can order it from us here at Prophecy in the News. This book sells for $34.95, and we want you to order it today. We have them in stock in the warehouse, and we got these out of Europe. The author and the publisher is in Europe from Sweden, and we were able to get a hold of this book and make it available to you. $34.95 plus shipping and handling. And Gary, I think that the people will just absolutely revel in this book.
Oh, J.R., there's no doubt about it. It's the most exciting book we've ever offered. I have yet, and this is a very interesting thing, I have yet to be holding a copy of this book that someone didn't come up and take it away from me. And then they wouldn't give it back. they want to keep it. Yes. Wait a minute. I can remember when we had one copy around here, and everybody fought over who would get to keep that copy. It is that exciting.
Yes. And, of course, we've offered the video on the Exodus Revealed. It's the pictures. You'll see the underwater camera go down and pick these pictures off of the sea floor. Mm-hmm. And it's absolutely fascinating. This is available to you for $19.95 plus shipping and handling. And if you'd like to have it in DVD form, the DVD is available. It has more footage than the VHS and is well worth the extra $5. This is $24.95 plus shipping and handling. Now, if you would like to order a video and the book, you can do so, and we've got an extra special offer we want to give you. Just call the 800 number at the bottom of the screen and order the VHS video, The Exodus Revealed, along with the book, The Exodus Case, for $54.90. Okay, $54.90 plus shipping and handling, and we will add a year subscription to our magazine, Prophecy in the News, a $29.95 yearly subscription. So don't forget, that's a bonus if you get both the video and the book together. Or if you want to order the DVD video, which has 3 hours of extra footage, that is the 1 hour program and then a couple of hours more of extra footage, and the book, that's $59.90 plus shipping and handling, and we will send you a year subscription of our magazine, $29.95 a subscription for free as a bonus if you get both the book and the video. So take your pick, whichever one you want, the VHS or the DVD. Now you can order the video separate or you can order the book separate. And from time to time through this program, we'll show you how you can do that. Gary, this is absolutely, to me, one of the most fascinating things. When I sat down in my living room and I looked at the Exodus Revealed video, I was captivated.
I've showed it to a number of people, J.R., and in a couple of cases, the people wanted to see it all over again. I've shown it twice in a row. The book, The Exodus Case, really is three books in one. The Exodus Case has part one, which dates the time and the life of Moses and the Pharaoh of the Exodus. Maybe you've wondered, who really was the Pharaoh when all the events described in Exodus occurred? Part two of the book takes the Israelites out across the desert and over to the Red Sea and the crossing of the Red Sea. And then part three of this book talks about the mountain of God, Mount Horeb. And it documents all of the sites and the historical events to be seen and found around the mountain of God. By the way, including J.R., satellite photographs of the mountain of God and the surrounding terrain. Just super fascinating.
Absolutely. So let's talk about that first part, Gary, the timing. Who was the Pharaoh of the Exodus? And you know, you and I have discussed this over the years. This is one of our preoccupations, try to figure out the dating. And I think the date that we'd come up with was just pretty well right on.
That's right. As a matter of fact, there's kind of an argument about when the Exodus occurred. There's an early date around 1450 B.C., and there are some who date it maybe a couple hundred years later, around 1230 to 1250 B.C. I think scholarship is pretty well frozen on that late date. But Dr. Moller, I think, really nails it, J.R. He shows that the early date of right around 1450 B.C. has to be the date. And the pharaohs, the dynasty, the 18th dynasty of pharaohs, who were on the throne at this time, were the house of Thutmose, T-H-U-T-M-O-S-E, Thutmose I, then Thutmose II, III, and then IV, and then came after that King Tut, Tutankhamun, mm-hmm. the boy king. And J.R., the events surrounding the Thutmose dynasty are fascinating. Thutmose, does that sound familiar? Mosa, Moses? Well, that's where the name came from.
Moses' name came from the house he was raised in.
It was his
adopted name.
That's right.
From the Moses family. And, of course, he's also got Hatshepsut here, which I think is right on target. Isn't it amazing?
Absolutely.
But here's the real kicker. When we come down to the Exodus and to the plagues, the firstborn sons of all the households of Egypt died. And one in particular, and we know him as King Tut, the boy king. He was buried in a beautiful golden sarcophagus. He was buried with all of the paraphernalia, the regalia of the royal family, and was discovered some years ago. Everybody worships, or shall I say, just goes goggle-eyed over King Tut. And as a matter of fact, according to this book, the premise of this book is that Pharaoh died in the Red Sea, and therefore they had an empty tomb. The tomb was prepared for his father, mm-hmm. and when the son died, and the father goes off to kill the enemy and dies in the Red Sea, then the boy child is buried in the father's tomb, and so he became known as Tutankhamun, King Tut.
So here's the way it, and by the way, you can find out all about these details and hundreds more in the book, but the way it shapes up is this way. Around 1486 B.C., at the end of the reign of Thutmose the First, Thutmose the Second was to come to the throne. Well, J.R., according to Dr. Moore, that would have been Moses. The Moses of the Bible was to be the second of the house of Thutmose. And then came the third, and then would have been Thutmose the Fourth. He would be the Pharaoh of the Exodus who perished in the Red Sea. His son, the boy king we call King Tut, would have been Thutmose the Fifth, but he never made it to the throne. So instead of being called Thutmose the Fifth, he's called Tutankhamun, King Tut. All of this is of just enormous interest, and this is a book that I believe you start reading it at 10 o'clock in the evening, you just won't be able to quit until the next morning.
Yes. When you get over to page 144, there is a papyrus that has been located in Egypt called the Ipuwer papyrus. And I want you to listen to just some of the things that this papyrus has to say. One of the statements from this papyrus says, "Let us go plunder." The mayor of the city goes unescorted. In other words, Pharaoh's army, which was the police state, died in the Red Sea. There was no one there to keep order, and so everyone just went plundering everybody else, and everybody got what they could. So there was no law, no order. It was all a mob society. And then he says, foreigners have become people everywhere. And also, foreigners are skilled in the works of the Delta. Well, this is a reference to the Israelites during the time of the plagues. And it goes on to say, one of the fourth statements here from this papyrus is, what the ancestors foretold has happened. And it's just a picture of one disaster after another, all because of the plagues and the Exodus.
Now, J.R., this Ipuwer papyrus has been well known to scholarship for some time. It's maybe 3 feet long or so. It's not very big, but it comes from the 19th dynasty. This is the dynasty that followed the dynasty that was in power during the events of the Exodus. And the 19th dynasty then was lamenting the fact that Egypt was essentially without food, without an economy, without real leadership. It was ravaged by a people out of control. There was no police force. Item 5 here says, quote, "We don't know what has happened in the land." It's just amazing. People are wondering in this papyrus.
Total chaos.
What's happened? Yeah, what's happened to us?
And he goes on to say, poor men have become men of wealth, gold, lapis, lazuli, silver, turquoise. Goes on, all are strung on the necks of the female slaves. Gold is lacking. That sounds like Israel has plundered the land, and when they take off for the promised land, they take all of Egypt's gold
and
jewels with them.
Absolutely.
Amazing. And then this seventh statement from this papyrus says, the river is blood. It doesn't say it's red like blood. It just says it's turned to blood. And then it says in the eighth statement, there is blood everywhere, no shortage of death. And it goes on to say, many dead are buried in the river. The tenth statement from this, exhausted are materials for every kind of craft. Lacking are grain, charcoal, trees have felled, branches stripped. Food is lacking, great hunger and suffering. Just goes on and on, Gary. And the interesting thing is, the final statement is, this guy says, if I knew where God is, I would serve him.
Hmm. How about that? God was dead. That is, the gods of Egypt were dead. And he who was to be the Pharaoh of Egypt, Moses, was used of God to deliver the people into the desert. And J.R., this is where the story picks up and gets interesting. You know, there's been so much controversy about the route of the Exodus. People said, well, they went across the little marshes there just to the east of Egypt, and they kind of tippy-toed ankle deep in wet grass, you know. Yeah. That was crossing the Red Sea. Not true. And Dr. Moller really goes out of his way to document the pathway they took.
I tell you, the pictures underneath that Red Sea on the sea floor are just phenomenal.
Yeah.
Especially the pictures of the horses. Rib cage here, got a picture of a horse's rib cage, and I got a picture of bones from cattle, and skulls mm-hmm. from horse's skull. Just really amazing.
I'm looking at Exodus chapter 14, where Pharaoh got all of his armies and he chased the Israelites into the desert. And we read here in Exodus 14, 7, and he took 600 chosen chariots, all the chariots of Egypt, and captains over every one of them. And the Lord hardened the heart of Pharaoh the king, and he pursued after the children of Israel, and the children of Israel went out with a high hand. In other words, they were in control. But the Egyptians pursued after them. All the horses and chariots of Pharaoh and his horsemen, his army, overtook them, encamping by the sea beside Pi-Hahirot before Baal-Zephon. And that's a mouthful, J.R., but what it means is, and Dr. Moller really, again, nails this one, this location, Baal-Zephon, has to be a certain location down on the west coast of the Red Sea. And here I'm looking at page 174, and you have a satellite photo of the place where the Israelites were trapped. And then he goes on to make the case for how they were trapped, how the Egyptians pursued, and what happened that destroyed mm-hmm. the Egyptians.
Amazing.
It is.
Now, I want to tell you again right quick how you can get a copy of this book, because we have just a limited amount of time, so listen up. This book sells in the bookstores for $34.95. That is, if you can find it in bookstores. It comes from Europe, and we have it available for you, ready to ship it out just for a phone call, and it'll cost you $34.95 plus shipping and handling. And we also want you to order The Exodus Revealed. It's the video that goes with the book, $19.95 for the VHS video. It's 1 hour long. And then if you like to have it on DVD, which has another 2 hours of footage, extra footage, this one is $24.95. And I want you to get either this DVD or the VHS. And here's the way you can do it. You can order either the book or the VHS or the DVD, whichever one you'd like, or you can order both the book and the video. If you order the book and the video $54.90 plus shipping and handling, I want to add a bonus. It is our magazine, Prophecy in the News, $29.95 year subscription, absolutely free if you order the book and the VHS. Or if you order the book and the DVD for $59.90, that's adding the two prices together, the $34.95 plus the $24.95. And if you'll order them both, just when you call the phone number at the bottom of the screen, tell them whether you want the DVD or the VHS along with the book, and we will send you the bonus, a year subscription to our magazine. So order today. We really need to hear from you. You will help us to be able to pay for airtime and stay on the air. We must hear from you in order to be able to keep this program on the air. And so, as we look back at these, Gary, there's so much here to talk about. We've talked about the location and this little peninsula down the, I think it's called the Nuwabi Peninsula,
mm-hmm. Yes.
On the western shore of the Gulf of Aqaba. And the 8-mile stretch across to the other shore is a shallow, sandy bottom. Everywhere else is treacherous.
And deep, very, very deep, J.R. The Red Sea can be over 1,000 meters deep on either side of this sort of spit of sand, very shallow and very soft sand, by the way, which would have drained nicely, it would have made good footing until the water came back. And all along that thing are yes. the remains of chariots and horses and the bodies of soldiers. J.R., we can't get away, however, today without discussing what I consider to be one of the most amazing parts of this book, and that has to do with the mountain of God. There are many pictures of Mount Horeb here showing the mountaintop, which is blackened when yes. the fire of God came down upon that mountaintop. And I'm looking at page 251. You can see the blackened top of this mountain. It's not a volcanic mountain at all. It was blackened from outside rather than inside. And then, and I know you want to spend some time talking about this, J.R., on page 245, 246, mm-hmm. there is a large rock that is split right down the middle, and it appears to be the rock struck by Moses to obtain water for the people.
Now, there is a picture on page 244 here, taken from the top of Mount Sinai, looking to the west, down into the valley floor, and you can see the rock in the middle of the valley floor.
Yes.
It just stands there. Where did it come from? How it got there is just amazing, because it was not a part of a mountain. We think sometimes that Moses went up to the side of the mountain and there was this boulder on the side of the mountain, you know, that had come down from the top or rolled down. That's not the way it is at all. This thing stands by itself in the middle of the valley floor.
And J.R., I'm looking at a picture here, in fact, three pictures on page 246, showing that the cleft in this rock goes right to the bottom of the rock. And where it is split, you can see that voluminous quantities of water have obviously spewed out of this thing at some time in the past. We're not talking about a trickle or a little spring or even an artesian well. We're talking about a river which has actually gouged and carved the hard rock of the desert floor. And, you know, I suspect that from that day until this, no water has flowed out of that thing. But back in those days, a literal river came out of it. You can see the picture for yourself. Seeing is believing.
Yeah. Now, the interesting thing about this rock is that it stands in the middle of the valley floor, just on a little hump of the hill, mm-hmm. and this thing stands up 60 feet tall as a 6-story building.
Yeah.
And it's split all the way, absolutely split. You can look, you can stand on one side of it and look through and see sky on the other side of it, because the thing is split all the way from the top to the bottom. And you can see how obviously this had to be the rock from which the water came in the days of Moses. And it's all here, page after page after page, in this fabulous book.
Now, J.R., there were not just a few Israelites, one or two or three dozen Israelites. Oh, no, no. There were thousands of Israelites that went off across the desert. And they encamped at the base of Mount Horeb. And here on page 255, I am looking at some of the artifacts they left behind. Their grain grinding equipment. This place is just littered with artifacts left behind by the Israelites at the encampment. It's amazing.
Well, you can imagine in this program today, we have just barely been able to touch on a few of the things, of the many things that are in this book. Over 300 pages, full color pages, and I want you to get it. You can order it from us here at Prophecy in the News by calling the telephone number at the bottom of your screen. Or you can write to us at Prophecy in the News, P.O. Box 7000, Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, 73153. The book is $34.95 plus shipping and handling. If you order this by itself, we'll be happy to send it right out to you. However, if you do not have the video that goes with it, and the underwater camera that shows all those chariot wheels and axles and paraphernalia on the sea floor, you can order it for $19.95 from Prophecy in the News. Or if you'd like to have the DVD version, which has 2 extra hours of footage, you can get this one for $24.95. Now, if you'd like to get both the book and the video, you can do so by just adding the prices together. And if you do, if you get the book and, say, the VHS for $54.90, I will add a bonus, a year subscription to our magazine, Prophecy in the News. If you'd like to get the book and the DVD video for $59.90 plus shipping and handling, I will also, of course, add the free year subscription to Prophecy in the News magazine. Will you call us today or write to us? We need to hear from you. Gary and I want you to know that our Lord is coming soon, and it seems as if he has kept everything in store for these last days to show the world that he is true and real.
Yeah, J.R., what this book means to me is that the Lord has sort of saved this last treasured archaeological site until the very last of the last days. And now it's prophetically time to unveil it. And that is exciting.
Indeed. You see, there is a God. He's a God of miracles. He's a God who can split the waters of the Red Sea. And I want you to know he can give you eternal life if you'll trust him today. This is J.R. Church and Gary Stearman. Until next time, keep looking up.
Prophecy in the News is a viewer-supported ministry sponsored by our many friends across America and in your area. For your gift of $10, you can receive a special edition of our current program on audio tape, or for a gift of $20, we'll send you our programs on videotape. For either order, call the 800 number on your screen right now.